Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am all very pink today. It's not Valentine's Day anymore, but I'm definitely still in the mood. And I actually just brought some roses that my boyfriend gave me, which I'm absolutely loving. And we're all very pink today. Pink, 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 everything is pink. I hope you like that color. Now, on that note, we're just gonna jump right into this video and we're gonna be testing out and talking about the quite hyped Maybelline Dream Radiant Liquid Hydrating Foundation. This is something I wanted to try because it's a new product and it's a very popular one already. People seem to really, really love it. And also Maybelline is a pretty staple brand for me. A lot of their products work beautifully. So I was like, Dream? Radiant? Yes. I am still in the middle of the day and in the middle of testing this product out, but so far I will tell you this product took me on a roller coaster ride. It started off very disappointing, honestly, and then it went up and then it went down and it went up, and now I'm still very much of a question mark as to how this foundation is going to turn out. I did take some notes on this product because I'm a studious little girl, and I'm gonna tell you what I researched because I like to know what I'm getting myself into. First of all, it is $13, so not actually very cheap for drugstore foundation, but not super expensive. It's still a more affordable brand, but it's definitely moving up. So I think some brands are starting to move towards like the middle of the price range, and Maybelline is one of them because this is $13 and it's not like as cheap as it used to be. I feel like products back in my days were like $7, $6, $5 for foundation, maybe $8, like that was like a big deal, $9 maybe, like for a really high-end product, but times they are changing. I will say right off the bat, the shade range is not impressive at all. It only has 20 shades and not of shade variation, not a lot of like light, medium, and dark colors, but also not a lot of shade undertone. So if you have a really yellow undertone or really pink undertone, you may not find that in your shade, which is a little bit disappointing because for me personally, I did not find a color that worked for me. So there is that, but we're just gonna move right past that because I spoke a lot about how the shade was off for me. Right on the bottle it says it has hyaluronic acid and collagen, which I don't know how much of that is something that's enticing to you. It's kind of like a nice thing, but it really isn't a deal breaker. What I care about is how does it apply, how much does it cover, and how does it make my skin look, and how does it last, and all of that stuff. Like more about the appearance of it. I don't buy it for the fancy ingredients in it because honestly I really don't think they're gonna do much, but it's still nice, a nice thing to have in there. It's supposed to be natural looking glow, lightweight, and medium finish. So that's like the general description of this foundation. I do have some acne, I do have oily skin, I do have some dryness, as I'm finding out today after applying this foundation. So I have a lot of issues. I do have some creasing issues with my smile lines. We're gonna be testing all of that out today because it's something that I care about, and I'm gonna share my findings with you guys in case you have any of those issues yourself. And last but not least, we're gonna look at the packaging because there's nothing really special about it except for the fact that it has a very blushy cap on it, which, I mean, I don't know why, but I'm obsessed with like blush pinky tones, if you cannot tell at the moment. So we're just gonna look at that really quickly, and it does have a pump. So if you are into a pump situation, then that is something you're gonna get with this. Okay, on that note, we're gonna move on along to the application, and I hope you guys enjoy this video. I know this is supposed to be medium coverage, and I'm hoping it is actually medium high. Because I need it. Let's go ahead and give this a try. I'm gonna do a half face first. It's going on kind of interesting. I feel like it's not really grabbing onto my skin too well. Wow, I'm really pale. Darn it. It's okay. I do have some powder that's actually a little bit darker for me, so I'm hoping that that would like work itself out because, you know, my goodness. I don't know if you're gonna get distracted with the color difference, but I'm just gonna quickly tell you my first impressions as I'm showing you my half face comparison. So this is my skin with nothing on it, and then this is the super pale side with the foundation on it. Now, the application was pretty smooth, except that when I first was applying it, it wasn't like grabbing onto the skin, it kept coming off with the sponge. You see how it's just like, it's like not wanting to grab onto the skin. Eventually it evens itself out, but initially it's kind of like, yeah. And it is really pleasantly radiant, as in like it's not super dewy, but I see that sheen that I love. I love when products have that sheeniness because I know that for somebody with oily and textury skin, super shiny products tend to accentuate all of the wrong things for me. So having something that is just a little bit sheeny is perfect, because then it's like healthy and sheeny and dewy and beautiful, but not like accentuating anything that I don't want to have accentuating it. If that makes any sense. It actually did cover up a good amount. It's not bad, but there's something about it that's like, I don't know, I see all of the dryness, all of my skin texture. Like right here, I mean, I have some dryness, I guess. I didn't really realize I had all this dryness until I applied this foundation. It's also a color that doesn't really match me, so maybe that is part of it. Also, as I'm doing this to my skin, to my face, I do feel that it's a little tacky. It feels a little oily. Doesn't look it, but it feels it. I'm gonna try to see if I can maybe apply a little bit more foundation, and then I'm gonna apply powder, and maybe that will help. I'll still continue on with the test, but first impressions, like first impressions, I don't know. I am going to try to apply a little bit more of this product, but I honestly will say that it reminds me of products, foundations in particular, that I used to use when I was in college. And I would try to get like cheaper products, but they would always be kind of like that, where they would just be like sitting on top of the skin, accentuating all the little dryness that I would have going on with my skin. They would always like cake and disintegrate really quickly throughout the day when I would start to produce oil. I honestly was so sure about this product, so I'm kind of shocked. But I tell you one thing, I do not want to have my foundation draw attention to my imperfections, because, you know. No. I don't know if it's gonna work out for me. I'm kind of already very suspicious of that, to be honest with you, but I'm gonna continue on with the test and we're gonna see how it goes. Okay, I'm gonna be using my trusty IT Cosmetics Your Skin But Better CC blah 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 powder, which I use all the time, partly because it's awesome and beautiful, but partly because the color is a little bit darker than my skin, and when I have situations like these and I need to color correct my face, this is my go-to product. I'm gonna take this ginormous brush from Morphe, which has 1,000,002 bristles, and you can pick up so much product on this brush and just like massively deposit a ton of powder on your face. I think my face is already getting some color back. It is looking better with the powder. However, this powder is supposed to be like an airbrush powder, so it's a smoothing type of a product. Okay, so there is like a little patch that's missing here. Oh my goodness, why? I mean, this foundation is not super easy to work with. It just comes off so quickly. Still really tacky. Okay, so my skin isn't looking too bad. It's actually looking quite nice with the powder. I don't know. I'm debating whether or not I should even continue with the test, because my skin is looking good, but I wouldn't say it's worth the hassle to get here. I'm just gonna do a quick little lean in. And my skin definitely recovered with the powder, but I'm going to run off and finish my makeup, and I'm going to come back and we're gonna see how this is gonna be doing. I'll be right back with the rest of my makeup. I was a little disappointing, I'll tell you. A little disappointed there. Okay guys, I'm back with everything all nice and done, and I do not know what to think here, because on the one hand, this foundation is not good at all in my experience, first impressions. On the other hand, my skin's looking good, so I guess I'm gonna continue on with the test because I want to see how it's gonna last. But let me just give you a closer look at what is going on here. I did apply, as far as the face is concerned, I did just apply some bronzer, some blush, a little bit of highlighter. My skin is looking smooth. I don't see as much of that dry, rough texture that it was so accentuating initially. It is creasing a little bit though already, but not too much. It's very lightweight and it's very like blurring looking. I wish it had higher coverage, but it's not supposed to, it's not designed to. And I can see somebody, including myself, actually using and loving this on days where their skin is just a little bit good, a little bit better than mine is right now. What happened up to this point is that the application went on kind of patchy, literally, because it wasn't grabbing onto the skin, the foundation. It kept like coming off. I would try to apply and it would apply, but then like come off. If I touched my skin, even with powder on, it would just kind of lift off. It was creasing a lot. It felt very tacky and like slippery. Literally just would not like stick to the skin. It must have had some sort of an oil in it or something that just made it kind of move around. It didn't cover a lot of the acne, but it did cover enough where with just a little bit of concealer and even without really, it was okay. So my skin is looking good. Like it's just looking very smooth and just a little bit radiant, not too much and not too little, just perfect amount. My initial thoughts, and even with my skin looking really really good, I would say it's like you know, because it's just, it was so finicky, hard to apply, it is probably gonna crease a lot. I'm just doing a prediction right now. It's like I can't say I'm in love with it, but I am intrigued because my skin is looking very good, like very healthy, like the way I'd want it to look naturally. Okay, so on that note, I'm going to continue on with my day and I'm gonna see you guys in a couple of seconds, but really a couple of hours in my time. So let me walk you through what happened today and let you form your own opinion on whether or not it's something that you want to try, because I can see how this foundation can work great for some skin types. And even for me, there were moments that I really enjoyed about this foundation and a few things that I did not. So first of all, when I started to apply this foundation, it seemed to kind of pull off my skin. I just wouldn't want to grab onto my skin, and that kind of held true for the rest of the day in the sense that it would come off really easily. There's a patch that's kind of missing from right here where I touched my skin lightly. If I press really hard, the foundation would come off. Not terribly so, but definitely enough for me to mention it right now. It's also creasing and just not really lasting super well. I did not touch anything up. I did not apply anything on top of my skin. I didn't actually produce that much oil today. I normally produce a little bit more oil than today, but this foundation still didn't really last that well, to be honest with you. Also, this foundation accentuated my dry skin. I didn't really honestly realize I had dry skin until I applied this foundation, and then I saw all of the little like flakes that I have, just I guess on a microscopic almost level, because you really don't see it from far away, but if you're up close you can see all of that texture and your skin is just not looking that smooth. So the lasting of it, the way it's kind of like sitting on top of the skin, the way it's accentuating that like that dryness, I don't love. What I do love about this foundation though is how smooth it's making my skin look. So from further away, my skin honestly looks really, really good. And the foundation isn't lasting terribly. It's not like super cakey. It's just not very smooth. It's almost like breaking apart a little bit. It's definitely creasing. It's kind of like sitting on top of the skin and accentuating that like texture I have going on with my skin. So let me just try to zoom in and see if I can maybe give you a better idea what I'm talking about. All right, I'm just gonna be nice and quiet for 1 second and let you form your own opinion on how everything is doing. I'm guessing if you have a very normal skin type and you want light coverage and kind of a smoothed out finish, this is probably gonna work really well and you don't mind it kind of not sticking to the skin super well. But if you care about that, if you have issues with your makeup lasting, if you have issues with your makeup coming off like that, if you have a lot of dryness, or if you have really, really oily skin, this may not be ideal, again, just from my experience. Okay, guys, on that note, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section below if you've tried this foundation out and what you think of it. I'm curious if you've experienced the same things that I have, or if it's maybe I have a bad bottle, or maybe the formulation just does not work with my skin. In any case, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope this was helpful. Thank you so much for all the love I get from you guys in the comment section below and the thumbs up. I really do appreciate it. And on that note, I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.